So basically I have in this app test metal 1 which we are going to develop during this tutorial video. Let me show you how this app runs. So if I just open it, it will show you a red color triangle on a yellow color background. So we will develop this app in our tutorial video. Let's see. Hello guys, so today I'm going to talk about metal shading language. Okay, and this is my first video, and I'm going to start a video series on metal on like some advanced use cases, debugging, how to debug fragment shader, debug vertex shader, how to do complex operations. But in this first video we will keep it very simple, and we'll know and learn how to draw a basic triangle using metal. Okay, let's start. So first of all, we should know that what are all devices currently supporting metal. So as you can see, all the devices equipped with A7 processors or higher are now able to use metal, which includes iPhone 5s, iPad mini, Air 6, 6 plus, 7, 8, and all the higher versions. Okay, and now after that, what we will do is we will create a basic project starting from the scratch, and we will include a metal file, write some shader, and draw a triangle, and we'll see it. So before writing any code, let me give you some basic information about some concepts regarding metal. And first thing is metal layer. So in iOS app, there's a view, and view's layer holds the actual content that get drawn on the screen. So basically whatever you draw on that layer, it is being shown to the screen. So for metal says that I have my own layer. So you have to change the UI view layer to the metal layer whenever you create an app for metal, right? And you, how you can do this is by overriding the layer class. Okay, so the third point says the CA metal layer binds metal and UI view together. Okay, and after that there is one more thing which you have to do. So in your storyboard we have a UI view, and in that UI view we have to bind that view to our metal view class, which we will create while coding. Okay, so basically you will create a metal view class in your code, and in your storyboard you will bind that class with your view. Concept of metal drawables. So basically what is our aim? Finally, our aim is to show the output what we have done, like we have drawn some triangle on the screen, right? So there is a concept of texture. So whatever you draw, whatever you do, basically finally rendered on a texture. Okay, and if you don't know the textures, I will describe it later in this video and in the future videos as well. So CA metal layer, so finally if you have drawn something on a texture, it will not be automatically shown on the screen, right? So if you want to show your output on the screen, what you have to do is metal gives you a drawable. So you have, from the metal layer, you have to ask a drawable, and that drawable has a texture inside it. So this is a special texture. So you can then ask a texture from the drawable, and whatever you draw on that texture now is being presented on the screen. Okay, we will see that how we are going to use drawable to show our output on the screen in the demo. So there are some important concepts before we start writing code. So these include metal device, metal command queue, and metal command before. So metal device is an abstraction of GPU. So ideally we have only one device in our app. And metal command queue. So metal command queue, as you can see, it contains a list of encoded commands which finally GPU use and to execute the commands. So ideally we have only one command queue in our whole app. Metal command buffer. So command buffer has a collection of render commands. Okay, so command buffer, you can have multiple command buffers in your app, but it depends on the scenario in which you are using. Right, for this simple app we will only have one command buffer. Okay, so Before drawing a triangle, you should also know about the coordinate system of the metal framework. So basically, I have given you a diagram over there, which basically shows that coordinate system of metal. So in metal, you can x-axis moves from minus 1 to plus 1, y-axis also moves from minus 1 to plus 1, and z-axis moves from 0 to 1. This is different from OGL. In OGL, z-axis also moves from minus 1 to plus 1. Okay, and also if you want to draw a triangle, you should also know how to write a shader code. Okay, so there are two shaders involved mostly in render pass, which are vertex shader and fragment shader. So we will also know how to write vertex shader and fragment shader in this video. After that, we should also know how to pass the desired vertices which you want to draw on the screen to the shader. Guys, I've created a demo app for you. Let's first go through this demo app, and after that we will start coding. So it will give you a heads up that what we are what is the end app will look like. Okay, so we will create two files, .h file for a view and the implementation file for a view. We will write a shader code in shader.metal file, and in metal storyboard we will update we will bind this view with our new view which we have created over here. Okay, so in this interface I have created some properties, some important things which we will need, like device, command queue, command buffer, a pipeline, and a vertex buffer. Okay, and in the view in the implementation file, we will first override the layer class, which will say that now this layer is of metal type, CA metal layer class. Okay, after that we will init our code. In the initialization, we will first create a device, and the device is created using metal create system default device. In the metal layer, we will attach the device and we will set the pixel format. This is mandatory thing which you have to do anyway. We'll create a command queue using device and command for using command queue. So this is essential thing which you have to do. So after done all these things, now we are ready to draw a vertex. Okay, so in the redraw vertex, what I will do is I have created a struct called vertex, which will describe my vertex. My vertex is all about position, its position and the vertex color. So I have created position is of type float 4, and color is also of type float 4. So basically a position contains x, y, z, and color contains RGB, comma alpha. Okay, so for a triangle we need three vertices, so I have created an array of three and I have updated it. So basically what I have done is my one vertices is pointing to x minus 1, y 0, and the color is red, and other vertices pointing to x 1, y 0, color is red, and the third vertice is pointing to x 0, y minus 1, and the color is red, R, G, B, and A. A for alpha. Alpha is always 1 because we are creating a solid rectangle. So now to use these vertices, you have to put these vertices in a vertex buffer, and you have to create a buffer for that. So for we have to create a buffer using device. So with device, there is a method called new buffer with bytes. So with bytes we are providing this buffer and the size of this buffer. Okay, and after that we'll get a vertex buffer. Metal gives you an API called new default library, which will help you access all the fragment and vertex function which you have created in .metal file. Okay, so I have created two functions, vertex shader and fragment shader, named as pass through vertex shader and pass through fragment shader. My pipeline will be using these two shaders. Okay, so I have extracted out vertex shader and fragment shader like this, and now I am first creating a pipeline descriptor, and my pipeline descriptor tells that pixel format will be of this, vertex shader is this, fragment shader is this. Okay, and now, we need to create a render pass descriptor. So render pass descriptor will help you in creating a render encoder. So basically you create a descriptor and that will end up giving you an encoder. Okay, So descriptor tells you about like what kind of operation which you want to do on the attachment. So basically it tells us that I want to clear my color with this. This is yellow, R1, G1, B0, alpha 1. It tells you that the destination texture is frame buffer texture. And frame buffer texture is that same texture which we got from the drawable. So it means whatever you draw on frame buffer texture will be drawn on the screen. Store action and load action are set to store and clear. And if you don't understand this, don't worry. We will discuss these things in later videos. Okay. And using this parse descriptor, I will create a render encoder using command. So basically command buffer will give you a render encoder. Okay. So now my command encoder is ready. So on my command encoder, I have to set a pipeline. So my pipeline will tell that these are the two vertex and these are the two shaders which you have to use. Vertex shader and fragment shader. So now encoder knows what shaders it has to use. Now encoder also need a buffer on which it has to operate, right? So for that I am setting three vertices using this vertex buffer which I have created over here. So I am doing this by using set vertex buffer. It is set. Now command encoder is ready to issue a draw call. So there is a draw call called draw primitive, MTL primitive type triangle. So it knows that it has to draw a triangle on the buffer which has been provided to it. So we will say that there is a vertex count of 3. So there are 3 vertices in it, right? And after this, we are done with this encoding. So we will issue add encoding command. When the command encoder says add encoding, it means it has done encoding all the things. Now we are now ready to show, right? So command buffer now issue that we are ready to present this drawable, right? We have taken the texture from this drawable only. After that we will issue a commit and done. Kept it as red. Vertex 2 I am changing it to green and vertex 3 I am changing it to blue. So now let's see what difference does it make on the output. Let us now test the output after changing the position. In this time we will render our triangle in the first quadrant. This vertex should move to first quadrant. Let's make it as 0, 0. Second vertex is already in the first quadrant. X is 1, Y is 0. Third vertex should be in vertex quadrant first. So writing shader in metal is pretty easy. So basically in shader we should again define the type of vertex we are expecting from the CPU. So this part of code is being executed by GPU and whatever we have written over here is being executed by CPU. Okay, so over here GPU should also understand that what type of vertex is being passed from the CPU. We are saying that position will be of type float 4 and it represents a position, and the color will be of also type float 4. So vertex shader, so whenever you write a shader, either vertex shader or fragment shader, you have to add a qualifier like vertex shader represent this is the vertex shader and fragment represent this is the fragment shader. So while writing vertex shader, I am expecting an array of vertices from the CPU, which will be on the index 0. As you can see, we have passed the vertex on index 0 over here on the encoder, so it will be available to us on the index 0. Okay, and this is a default parameter which will be given to you, like on which vertex ID this vertex shader is currently running. So there are 3 vertices, right? So vertex shader is being called 3 times. So and for each time VID will give you 1012. So this is a plain pass through vertex shader. Over here I am doing nothing, I am just returning the vertex as it is. I am not doing any complex operation on top of it. Okay, so and after that this code and there is a whole pipeline in graphics pipeline. There are a couple of stages in between vertex shader and fragment shader which we are not going to discuss in this video, and maybe in future video we will discuss it. And finally the fragment shader is being executed by the GPU and it says that you have to operate on this vertex. This vertex is in a stage vertex. So basically fragment shader is being called for all the vertices, all the pixels which are there in your triangle, right? Not three times, it will be so many times, it will be called so many times parallelly. Okay, so over here ideally the major work of fragment shader is to return the color. So over here we are returning in float4 the color of the vertices, incoming vertices. Thank you guys.